In this lecture, we will create, alter, drop database tables using MySQL Workbench. I have opened MySQL Workbench and logged in my MySQL database server using root username and password. Create a new database by right-clicking the schemas area and selecting Create Schema menu. In New Schema window screen, enter the new database name. In my case, I will use MyTestDB. Use default collation. Click Apply button, Apply, and Finish. Under Schemas menu, select the newly created database. In my case, MyTestDB. Double click the database name. It will display the submenu under the database. The submenu contains the tables, views, stored procedures, and functions. At this moment, we have just created the database, so there are no tables or other information stored in it. Select Tables submenu, right click on it, and select Create Table option. We can also click this Create New Table icon to create a new table under the selected database. On the new table screen, enter the table name. I will use students. Use default collation and default engine. Click inside the middle window and type column name here. Let's create the student table here, which we saw in practical examples. In column name, type student ID. Data type int, that is integer. Select PK checkbox to make the column primary key. Remember, primary key don't store null values. So MySQL Workbench automatically checks NN means not null option. Select unique checkbox to store only unique values. The B checkbox is used to store only binary values, that is the values contains only 1 and zeros. UN checkbox means unsigned data type. This option is only used for numbers which stored either positive or negative values. We will be storing all the positive values in our student ID column. So we will select unsigned option. ZF means zero fill the column with zero values. AI option for auto increment. We are not going to manually enter each student ID, so we will select the system's auto increment option. The student's ID and store the unique values by selecting the auto increment option. This G option for generated columns used for advanced use like expression caching, provide join index for non-relational data, etc. In the default or expression option, we can store a default value for the data column. Enter the second column name, first name. The data type varchar 20 characters long. NN for not null. Enter another column, last name. Again varchar, 20 characters long, NN for not null. Enter new column, class, data type, varchar, 10 characters long, NN for not null. And finally, age column, which will be an unsigned integer. Select int and un for unsigned. Click apply button to save the changes. It opens SQL statement window. Click apply button to execute the statement and finish to save the changes. Now under schemas menu, under the selected database, the tables link will contain the newly created table. We can select the table name to open the table detail screen. On this screen, we can modify the table. We can select the table name to open the table detail screen. We can modify the column name, data type, and other table setting from here. To delete the table, simply select the table name and right-click on it and select Drop Table option. Select Drop Now option to instantly delete the table from the database.